Hello everyone, this is Prabhakaran. Hope you are all doing good and fine. In this particular video, we are going to discuss about parallelization in multi-core architecture and programming. So, what are the contents that we are going to deal in this video is, we are going to discuss about serial and parallel processing, that is serial and parallel computing. And we are going to discuss about what are the drawbacks over there in the serial programming. And in the parallel processing, where we are going to use in the real-time example and also in the multi-core process. With one scenario, that is we are taking the example of the tree search in this particular parallel programming. And with the tree search, we are going to deal with where the tree search is actually used in the real-world example and computation examples. Followed by, we are going to solve with the tree search problems. Let that enter into the video.
Before starting, let us see actually what is serial versus parallel programming. Before taking a toll on parallel computing, first let's take a look at the background of computation of a computer software and why it failed for the modern era. Computer software were written conventionally for serial computing. Yes, this means that to solve a problem, the particular algorithm will get divided into the smaller instructions. These discrete instructions are then executed on central processing unit of a computer one by one. That is, one after another. Only after one instruction is finished, the next one will get started to execute, right? Now let's compare this with the real life example. See, when two people were standing in a queue waiting for a movie ticket, and there is only one cashier. If that particular cashier is giving ticket one by one to the person, the complexity of the situation increases when there are two queues and only one cashier is available. Problems in serial processing. So in short, serial computing will have n number of problems. The first thing is, in this, a problem statement is broken into the discrete instructions. Second, and then the instructions are executed one after one, and only one instruction will get executed at a moment of time. Now take a close look at the point 3. This was causing a huge problem in computing industry, as only one instruction was getting executed at any moment of time. This was a huge waste of hardware resources, as only one part of the hardware will be running for a particular instruction end of time, right? As problem statements were getting heavier and bulkier, so does the amount of time in execution of those statements will get increased. Examples of processes involved in that are Pentium 3 and Pentium 4. Now let's come back to that real life problem which we discussed in the previous slide. We could definitely say that the complexity will decrease when there are two queues and two cashier giving tickets to two persons. First, come out of the parallel processing in computation field. Let us focus how the parallel processing actually works in our real time. Okay, now take a close look at this picture. You are alive today because your brain is able to do a few things at the same time. Yes, absolutely, our brain is doing multiple tasks at the same time. And meanwhile, we are not focusedly going to talk about that multitasking, like folding laundry or talking to friends on a phone at the same time. We are referring to parallel processing in the sense the brain's ability to make sense of several different incoming stimuli at the same time. Think about driving your car down the street, like in this picture. Think about driving your car down the street. Your brain is constantly taking in information through your senses, right? Your brain is constantly taking in information through your senses. What you are seeing, what you are hearing, and sometimes what you feel and smell. This all happens at the same time, right? In this particular image, you can see, you don't first notice the shape of the stop sign over there, then the color, then the letters, then the message behind that sign. Instead, your brain takes all the stimuli in at once, along with lot of other background information. You can see like a dog getting ready to run into the road, process it and send signal to your muscles telling them to step onto the brake. Now let us take a close look about how the parallel processing is actually used in the multi-core architecture. Okay, so see the first point. Most of the processor in the desktop and the laptops are dual core, or it will be a quad core. Means more than one core exists in a processor, each of which are capable of computation and processing, right? Second, but most of the cores, sure, it will be in the idle state. Basically, you can see that in your computer, if you are using the Windows operating system, go to the CPU usage in the task manager and click on the performance. It will show the what are the cores which are tend to be in an ideal state. Okay, I'm repeating again. If you are using the Windows, see the CPU usage using, go to the task manager, and in that you can see in the performance of the CPU. Third point, parallel processing uses multiple cores. Yes, absolutely, parallel processing will get to use all the cores available over there in the multi-cores or the multi-processor, which are available. Advantages of parallel computing over the serial computing. First advantage will be, it saves time and money, as many resources working together will reduce the time and cut the potential cost. Second thing, it can be impractical to solve large problems on a serial computing, because it will take a number of time and the completion of that particular task will get to be larger when compared to parallel computing. Okay, third, it can take advantage of non-local resources when the local resources are finite. The parallel computing will take all the non-local resources. Okay, serial computing wastes the potential computing power absolutely. Parallelization. Basically, during parallelization, the programmer must ensure that the parallel programs are being executed in fork join method, fork join model, because fork join method would result without any bugs or without any data race conditions. Now, what actually is fork join model? Look into this picture. When the programmer get to started with a single thread, okay, the single thread will be called as a master thread. That master thread will get entered into the fork and it will get splitted into n number of multiple threads. At start of the parallel region, master thread creates the team of parallel worker thread. The first thread 0 will be called as the master thread, and followed by the thread 1, thread 2, thread 3 are called as a worker thread. Fork statement in a parallel blocks are executed in a parallel by every threads. At the end of the parallel region, all the threads synchronize and join as a master thread again for the completion of the task. Now, in this parallelization, we are going to consider a problem or going to consider a scenario called as tree search for the implementation of parallelization in multicore, which will get enlarged with the help of the OpenMP. Introduction to tree search. Most applications use tree search to find out the feasible solution. Based on the problem statement, tree would be constructed ever. And tree has two types of nodes, root node followed by the non-root nodes. At bottom of each subtree, there will be no designated node exist. Absolutely, these nodes are termed as the leaf nodes. Yes, tree search can be carried out in both DFS and BFS, that is depth first search and breadth first search. Insertion and deletion of all the elements available there in the tree is carried out to maintain the tree balance. Yes, so to the introduction to tree search, we need to concentrate on some of the important point that it will give a feasible solution. And problem statement is most important. Examples of hierarchies. A tree structure or tree diagram is a way of representing the hierarchical nature of a structure in a graphical form. It is named as a tree structure basically. Whenever you have to represent a hierarchy, you could use a tree, right? Some of the examples of hierarchies which I mentioned here is the time, geography and ancestry. And we have n number of examples too. basically you can see in the picture that the time represents the year, month, day, hour, followed by the minutes and then seconds. The hierarchy goes on. Meanwhile, in geography, you can see the district, region, followed by the territory. And in ancestry, you can mention some of the grandparent, parent, child, grandchild, and so on. So there are a number of examples in the way of representing the hierarchies. For each of the above, the hierarchy can be represented by a tree. And the implementation could be done via some node object, which basically has two fields. The thing is that parent is the first field, which will be called as the type node. And the children will be the second field, which will be called as the collection of nodes. In addition to the above two fields, you could usually have some domain specific behavior and some of. Now we will look after what are the real-time applications of trees. Basically, one reason to use trees might be because you want to store information that naturally forms a hierarchy. See, in the following real-time example, we have computer chess games, cell phone future, hard disk file system, PDF, that is portable document format, and company organization structures. When you look into the computer chess game, basically it build a huge tree, that is a training, which they prune at runtime using the heuristics to reach an optimal move. Look into the second one, the cell phone future. Your cell phone future, where your contacts get listed the moment when you start typing his or her name using the tree structure, that is gets involved over there. And now hard disk file system. C drive has many folders. Each folders can in turn have many folders, etc, etc, and so on it goes on. Assume each folder a non-leaf node and a file as the leaf nodes. Generally, it too forms a tree data structure. Fourth real-time example is PDF, that is a portable document format. PDF is a tree-based format. It has a root node followed by the catalog node. These are often the same. Followed by a page nodes, which has several child page nodes. Yeah. Now, toward the fifth real-time example is company organization structures. Basically, in every company, there will be some reporting authority over there. A gets reports to B, where B and C reports to D. Now, in this picture, you can see that the position varies, where CEO has three sectors or three partitions over there. And one was marketing, second one was sales, and then the third one was service. When come to the computer applications of tree, we will deal with the network routing, HTML, DOM, finally the syntax tree in compiler. In network routing, basically the tree routing is an extremely simple routing algorithm where a node only forwards packets to its parent or child nodes, followed by the HTML document object model DOM. All HTML text attributes are stored in tree called as document object model. It follows the tree structure. And now in the syntax tree in compiler, where in compiler every expression is converted into syntax tree for. Now the another computer application of trees is artificial intelligence game. In this artificial intelligence game, the opponent will be the CPU and the next moves are stored using the tree. Now, tree search problem, TSP. Tree search problem is mostly depend on non-deterministic polynomial, a complete NP program, NP complete program. The objective of the TSP, that is a tree search problem, is to find a minimum cost tour. In TSP, N cities to be visited or given as an input. Basically, the input will be the N number of cities, okay? The salesman, consider an example. The salesman has to start his travel from his hometown. Okay, the salesman has to start his travel from the hometown and visit all the cities exactly once with the minimum cost. Yes? Then finally, the person has to reach his own city from where he started. The process of visiting each city exactly once and returning back to his own city is called as tour. Number of possible solution to the tree search problem grows exponentially when we have number of cities increased. Okay, that is, there are two types of tree search problem. The first thing is symmetric TSP and the second one is asymmetric TSP. Symmetric TSP, distance between the two cities is same in both direction. If A to B or from B to A, the distance will be same. It is an undirected weighted graph. Okay, basically the symmetric TSP deals with an undirected weighted graph. Vertices denotes cities, edges connect them, and weight of the edge is the distance between two cities. Now when come to the asymmetric TSP, path may not exist in both direction. Path will not be exist in both direction. It goes on with a directed graph. If it cases from A to B or else from B to A. Distance might be different in the opposite direction. Yes. Now look into this picture of directed and undirected graph. First, in the undirected graph, A to B we have a weight of 2. If we consider from A to B, it will be 2. And also from B to A, it will.
Thank you so much for your patience listening. Stay connected. Do good.